So let's take up next question. It's a sphere. Number here, sphere one. Perfect. Okay. Sphere of mass m, radius r. It is. It has been given of angular velocity of v naught by 2r, and the velocity of center of mass is given as v naught. Okay, will it pure roll on the surface?
No,
it will not.
No.
Okay, suppose coefficient of friction is given to you. Mu is the coefficient of friction. Alright, you need to find time.
So it's rolling this way.
You need to find time. Please write down time after which pure rolling will start. And you need to find VCM and omega at that point. Do it. See, most of the questions you are solving today, you will not get it the first time. And that's the whole idea. So that you learn something. If you are able to solve all the questions, you are wasting your time. Here. I will give 2 plus 2, tell you how much it is. 5 plus 5 minus 3, how much? You will answer, you feel good about yourself. Go back home happy. But you will not learn anything. What is the velocity of the bottommost point? Omega into r this way, which is what?
V naught by 2.
This side V naught by 2, omega into r, and that side? V naught. So total velocity is V naught by 2 this way. So friction will act in backward direction. And what is the value of friction? Mu times normal direction or not? It is sliding. So this is mg and this is normal reaction. This will be mu times normal reaction. It is sliding, right? The point of contact is sliding. So friction is mu times m. It is not a static friction. You can do it. You find the acceleration, find out the angular acceleration using torque equation. And then how much?
So V naught by 7 meters.
Find out the velocity. V will be how much?
6 by 7.
6 by 7, correct. Answer. How much will be the acceleration of this?
Yes, it's about that.
What is the force acting on it? Mu times normal reaction, which is mu mg. This is equal to m into a. So a will be mu g, which were backside. So it is deceleration. Okay, and then torque equation if you apply. Torque because of friction will be mu mg into r. This will be what? It's a sphere. Torque equal to I alpha, 2 by 5 mr square I times alpha. Torque about center of mass is equal to ICM into alpha. Okay, so alpha will come out to be 5 mu g by 2r. Alpha is angular acceleration or deceleration? It is angular acceleration. A is deceleration, alpha is acceleration. Okay, so velocity after time t will be equal to v naught, since it is deceleration, minus mu g t, and omega after time t is omega naught, which is v naught by 2r, plus alpha, which is 5 mu g by 2r into t. Understood this? V is equal to u plus at, omega is equal to omega naught plus alpha t. Okay, suppose t is a time after which pure rolling starts, then at that time v by r should be equal to omega, or v should be equal to omega r. Just multiply R with this and equate to that, you'll get T. And once you get T, substitute here to get V and substitute here to get omega. Got it? Any doubts? कोई डाउट नहीं है, नो डाउट्स, ठीक है, इट्स अ स्फीयर, अ स्ट्रिंग इज वाउंड ओवर इट, एंड यू आर पुलिंग वन एंड द स्ट्रिंग विद अ फोर्स एफ. Okay, friction is sufficient for pure rolling. Okay, the radius is R, it's a sphere of mass M. You need to find these things, A, center of mass, alpha, and the value of friction. What is F? F is not given to you. You have to find what is F. Capital F. Oh, sorry. No. Torque. Who are applying torque on this about center of mass? F and friction. Both are there. You might be wondering about direction of friction. It doesn't matter. You can take any direction. Okay. If it is wrong, it will come out to be negative. Since it is a pure rolling, guys, since it is a pure rolling, there will be a static friction, and static friction can range from 0 to maximum value. It can be anything. Okay? It's not a constant friction. Only when sliding happens, you can say friction is mu n. How are you? Done? So first step is to draw the free body diagram. Which side the friction will be? I don't know. So I'll take anything. You can take right or left, but many of you are saying left.
It turns out to be right.
It'll be right, yeah.
It is right.
Kahin bhi le lo, it doesn't matter. Is FR?
No.
Alright, so this will have, let's say, alpha and ACM. This is the free body diagram. You must start like this. So net force in the horizontal direction is what? F minus FR. This should be equal to M into
ACM.
This is your Newton's second law equation. And the torque equation for the object which is rotating. This object is rotating. So FR plus, both are rotating in the same direction, isn't it? Both are clockwise. This is the net torque, this is equal to 2 by 5 mr square alpha. Okay? And since it is a pure rolling on a fixed surface, alpha into r is acm. So, three equations, three variables. Anybody solved it?
Yes.
Also,
friction is towards the right.
No, sir, friction equal to mu mg, right? Because there are four variables.
No.
Where are four variables? FR, alpha and A. What else? How much FR are you getting friction as?
3/10 mg.
3/10 mg?
MA. Oh wait, A is also.
You're getting in terms of unknown.
Yes.
Solve it. Quickly tell me what is friction. Solve these equations. Tell me what is friction.
So it's 3F/7. Friction 3F/7.
3F by 7. Yeah, yes. Yeah. 3 by 7. It'll get 3F by 7.
So
3F by 7. Okay. See, it doesn't depend on mass friction.
It's really weird.
Right? This is what the rolling friction is. It can be anything. See, it actually, mass has an effect of friction, effect on friction, but friction has to be equal to this for pure rolling. It should adjust itself to this value. if let us say mass is lighter, the maximum value of friction may not be equal to 3F by 7. Then it will never be having pure rolling. If mass is heavier, then maximum value can go beyond 3F by 7 and that can pure roll. Are you getting it? But for pure rolling, this much friction must be supplied. If friction maximum value is less than this, it can't have pure rolling. Alright? So this must be greater than or equal to mu mg. Alright, let's do this. Let's take a test now. Why are you tearing your pages? क्या कर रहे
तू?
नहीं, he brought his book.
हाँ? That was AP.
क्या?
That was AP physics.
तो अपना book फाड़ना तो किसी और का book क्यों फाड़ रहा है? You are giving him pages. He has a book to tear off the pages. He's exploiting your friendship. Don't be friends with him. Bad person. Alright, so this is... It's a solid sphere. Huh? No, I've changed my mind. Should I keep it as this? It's a solid sphere. Stop talking. Mass m, radius r. This side, friction is sufficient for pure rolling. Alright? This height is, let's say, h1. Okay? This surface is smooth. Okay? You need to find out till what height the sphere will reach over here. Now don't talk. Don't talk. Solve this. Try this. Start from height h1, goes to height h2, find out relation between h1 and h2.
So assuming both those arms to be straight, right?
What? Horizontal. Sorry, this is inclined plane. That is also inclined plane.
So is it a disc?
Sphere. Solid sphere.
H1 is equal to.
Friction is different.
But for pure rolling, friction does no
more. Alright, if you are getting H1 equal to H2, that is wrong. Alright, that is the hint. Done. Okay, bhai. Tell me which one will be higher, H1 or H2?
H2.
No, it's H2 is lesser.
H1 is higher.
H1 is higher.
Should I solve?
No, sir. So is it h by h2 is equal to 7 by 5?
No, I mean, just made it up.
So h2 is more.
How can it be more?
No, h1 because, will be more.
Because it gains some rotation which it can't lose because it's smooth.
Okay guys, so here is one final hint. See, what will happen is that when it rolls down, it will gain what kind of kinetic energy? Rotation as translation. Rotation is half ICM omega square and translation is half MVCM square. Alright? When it is going in a smooth, this thing, there is no torque about center of mass. Friction is not there. So, if you draw the free body diagram, this is mg, normal reaction, that's it. So, the angular acceleration will not be there. So, omega will be constant throughout. So, it will, even if it stops here, it will keep on spinning with whatever angular velocity it had acquired over here. right? So omega cannot be decreased, fine? And hence, whatever rotation energy it has acquired here cannot be converted into potential energy. Are you getting it? All right? Only translation energy, half mvcm square will be equal to mgh2. Half I omega square you have to eliminate. Are you getting it? Now do it quickly. Should I do it? I'll write the expression down. There are the equations. This energy cannot be utilized. It will be as it is. Okay? So it says that if friction would have been there for it to pure roll, it will go higher. If it is smooth, it will not go higher.
Come on. So if there's friction on this side also, then would the height be the same actually?
Then if pure rolling both sides. I said that rotation energy can't be utilized because omega will be constant. It's smooth, no? That is why rotation energy can't be utilized.
No, like you said when it's smooth, it can't go higher. When it
does friction, correct.
It goes higher.
Yes. Yeah, because if it is friction is there for pure roll, you will utilize this also. Then this plus this will be equal to mgh2. But if friction is not there, this will not convert into potential energy. This will remain as it is. Only this one will convert into mgh2. But friction should be sufficient for pure rolling. Okay?
So what
they
get potential energy also when it is
bottom? Yeah, correct. I am assuming that radius is very less compared to H.
No, but I didn't like.
You did not like it.
No, I did it the other way. Like I didn't.
So you can keep it there also.
But
I mean, you get cancelled away.
Cancel.
Yeah,
is it 7:5?
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever comes. This is H1 minus R, you can say. This is H2 minus. What?
So you can work done by the friction one or in the box.
Where? Here? No, no. Work done is zero always. If it is pure rolling, work done by the friction is zero. Okay. Are you finding it tough? Okay.